Hiya! Thank you for joining us virtually for one of Mimbre's classes. This class has been recorded from a Zoom class that we did, which is an app where we can be more interactive with participants. But then we had requests to put it available on YouTube for those who can join us for that class. So it's a little bit weird because it's recorded from an interactive class. So maybe some of it won't make sense, or we'll, you know, mention things on the camera that doesn't quite make sense for you in your living room. But we hope it's useful for you to keep you moving, to have some fun. And if you want to join us for our interactive classes, they are on Tuesdays. And please sign up if you email info@mimbre.co.uk. Brilliant. Enjoy the class. Take care. Listen to your body. Have fun.
Find a space. Make sure you're not going to bump into anything. Get those feet going. Just get marching. Good. We're going to slide around the room. Sliding. Little jumps. Happy jumps. Happy dancing. Twist it. Twisting. Run on the spot. Faster. Turn around. Breathing it. Stretch and out. And stretch. And we're going to do some really funky bounces. Pull your arms up. Really bouncing. And then one leg out. One leg in. One leg out. One leg in. A little bit faster. Come on, you man, let's go. We've got a party to get on.
And then hula hoop on your hips. Circles.
over shoulder. We're going to go drop. We're going to go back. We're going to go cross. We're going to go shoulder. We're going to go drop. We're going to go back. Faster. Disco roll, go! High, low. Disco roll, side again. High and low. Push the ceiling. Push the floor. Push the ceiling. Push the floor. Jump around. Ready? Show me number one. Number one. You've got to keep bouncing. Number one. Good. Show me number two. Oh, yeah. Looking good. Show me number three. Good. Show me the last one. Pose number four. Go. Bounce it. Really good. All right, we are going to do a quick follow the leader routine. Keep bouncing. Here we go. You're going to freestyle here. And then you're going to follow me, man. Two smurfs, two disco roll. Go. Disco roll. Do that again. And you feel like life's no piece of cake. palms forward to the camera. Cross. Go back. Crisscross. Arms to be just deep. Do them again. You're going to stretch it out. Drop one arm. Drop the other. You're going to just arms up. You're going to catch a fly. Other way. You're going to disappear. Freestyle. Freestyle again. We're going to do the same thing, or freestyle there. We're going to do the smurf again, go. Disco roll. Do that again. This time, disco roll down. Come forward to me. Crisscross. Go back. Crisscross. Arms. Do it again. Jump it out. Drop an arm. One arm up. Both arms up. Catch a fly. This time we're going to go low as well. Do that faster. High, high, low, low, drop. Freestyle. Freestyle. Pose. Freestyle. Pose. Follow me. You're going to do a cross. Spin. Low. Can you run around your hand? Coming up. Then you're going to hold a pose. Freestyle. Pose. Freestyle. Pose. One more. Hold it. Best pose. Really well done. I liked all your poses.
So let's go on the floor and then just walk the hands around a bit. Right? And then we want to warm up your back. So dropping your back, being a happy cow. Whoa. And then an angry cat. Happy cow. And an angry cat. Meow. And those of you will be able to go lower down than this. You'll be able to arch more. My back is quite stiff nowadays. So really try to like push it up and push it down as much as you can. And then I'd like to try this with using either a sofa or a chair. So you're going to put your feet on the sofa. And then you're going to drop yourself down. You drop your pelvic, like your tummy towards the floor. And then you're going to pull up and push your belly button up to the ceiling. And we do five of those. So we're like both strength and stretching. Down. And then we push up. And go down. Three. And then we push up. Down. Four. And then we push up. Pull your belly button. Like you imagine it's your belly button leading everything. And then push up. Great. And we'll come out of that. And then let's do a little bit of legs. So put your legs in front of you. Let's go on the floor for this one. Put your leg in front of you. And we imagine we have little spiders on our fingers. So you're going to walk the spiders, walk your fingers forward. See how far you can reach. When you feel it stretching on your legs, take a deep breath in. And then deep breath out, go a little bit further. And then take a deep breath in. And a breath out, go a little bit further. And tiny bit further with your spider fingers. Great. Great. Then take one hand. So your hand is going to your opposite foot. Grab hold of that foot and then open up with your other hand behind you. So you're crossing your arm. Now grab the other leg with your foot. So these are my like this. These are my hands. It's the opposite hand to foot. Yeah, so I'm crossing my hands to reach the other foot. That's it. And the other ones will be behind me. Then I change hand. So this is my right hand. It goes to the outside of my left foot. And then I reach behind me. And look behind me. Cool. Okay. So then what we're going to do is we're going to warm up the knees and the back a little bit more with some of the moves we were doing with sofa. So I want you to stand holding your hands on your knees. And then you're going to push your knees forward. Actually, just do little circles with the knees. The angle I'm on, I'm getting a very strange perspective. My head becomes ginormous. And go the other way. Okay, then we're going to do, stand so you have either a sofa or the chair behind you. I'll do it on the sofa first, then I'll show you how to do it on the chair. And then you're going to look behind you. Just check where the sofa is. That's fine, I can reach it. What you're going to do is you're going to take the arm above your head and then reach the sofa. So I'm pushing my knees forward. I'm going to do it to this chair, but sideways. So you stand here. I check that I can actually reach it. And then I go up. I push my knees forward. I push my hips forward. And I push my tummy up. We get like a nice little C shape here. That's it. And back. And then we go on the other side. I just check where the chair is, so I'm not going to miss it. And then I go up. I look around, I push my hips forward, I push my arms, and I reach. And I come back. And when you come back, so Matilda, to come back, when I'm here, I'm thinking of, again, pushing my hips and my belly button, pushing that forward. So it's like I'm coming, yeah, that's it. So I'm coming out of this C, like, isn't it like this hand is like reaching. And I'm keeping that arch come out of it. Cool, let's do a couple more. So we go. Knees on our hands. And then one hand goes up and over and into the sea. So it's nearly like a bridge. It's like a half bridge onto the sofa. And come forward. And then the other way. And then come out of that. Great. Okay, let's do some handstands on and using the sofa or a chair. So start with sitting out on chair or sofa. Your hands just in front of your feet, and then go and walk your feet up on the sofa and look at the sofa and see if you can push your face towards the sofa. So I'm just going to show it from the side. I'm here putting my hands, I put my feet on my chair or sofa, and then I try to, like, you see how straight up I go with my body. So I'm actually looking at this chair and I hold it. And then I go down. And then shake your hand. Let's do five of those. So, handstands with the help of the sofa. Hands on the floor. Put the feet up. Push the floor away. Keep your feet on the sofa, but push the straight legs. And step down. And then back on the sofa. Yeah, there we go. Three more. So, hands on the floor. Feet back up on the sofa. Let's hold it for a little bit longer so we get stronger. Go into the handstand and we go 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and come out of it. There, and we're going to do one more like that. Okay, so. Right, this time we're going to take one leg up. Make sure you still have weight on the sofa. I don't want you to try to kick over or anything because then you might fall out of it. So I really want you to still keep the weight on the sofa or the chair. But once I've gone up with both legs, I'm just going to reach one up to the ceiling. I still keep weight onto my foot, but the other one is up to the ceiling. And then I change, the other leg is up. Don't go up, keep going. Okay. And then from there, I walk my feet down, and I sit down. And I shake back. If you end up finding it hard to get your bum up in the air, you probably want to put your hands a bit closer in. Because if I put them here, then I can't really go into the handstand. But if I put my hands just where my feet are, a little bit further, and then the way you place the feet is I place the just underneath the toes, this front bit of the foot. That's what I'll say so far. Yeah, not the leg like that. I'm flexing and pushing with my toes. See how my feet are like. Now this could be on a sofa or on a chair. I'm just sit on a chair, cross one leg over. Don't just do a turn. What I'm going to do is this foot. I want you to look for the floor with that foot. Reaches the floor, the sofa or the chair. I want you to push around, and so you come back sitting the other way. That's it. Great. And then play with how fast you can do that. And so, like, and also play with, do you need the hands? Maybe see if you can go here. I put the foot down. Maybe I can reach my hands up. And it's just about pushing with the leg. So actually, when I turn, I keep both my feet on the floor. So here's one foot. This one reaches down. Now look at my feet. They stay on the floor. They just swivel around on the toes. So again, my foot is here, so I can swivel. So they swivel around until I can sit down again. So if one leg goes over, that's the way you're turning. You're turning into that. Okay, I got another one. Again, this one, either you do it on a sofa or you can do it on the floor. So on the sofa, I find it slightly easier, I think. So we're going to sit with our legs crossed, and the leg that's like in front, yeah, so that's the way that foot is pointing, that's where I'm going to turn. So I'm going to put my hand and turn around and then look at the camera between my legs. And I keep using my hands to turn around and see if I can come sit cross-legged the other way. You can do this on the floor as well. Let's go here. So hands, walking around, coming back down again. So once you start turning, once you see me between the legs, you just keep going and then bend your knees and they just magically flap back again. So you go here, I put my hands, like I'm reaching my hands the way I'm going to go. So I push the floor to be able to come off my leg. Then I walk my hands around front. Go one more the other way. One more time. Right, so I see. You go up, use the sofa, use the armrest of the back, and take yourself right. Now, let's do some headstands. So, you can do them two ways. If you have a wall behind the sofa, then you can do them in the sofa. If you have a chair, make sure that the chair is blocked against something. So, if you do it in the sofa, then you can either do it with the armrest here or in the corner, and you put your head down. Get your back against the backrest. Push with your hands to lift up your feet. And then you can try to do some shapes there with your feet. Straddles. Side them up. Stone. Straight. A bit tricky going straight without putting too much weight on your head because you're at a weird angle. So just be a little bit careful about it. If you want to try to work a bit more on getting your head some balance, then that's just putting a pillow beneath the sofa, and this is for if you have a chair as well. And then you're going to go, I'm putting my head down a little bit away from the sofa, then I'm moving myself in until I can feel the armrest of the sofa against my back. Then from here, take one leg up, push with my hands, lift the other leg up. So this, I'm leaning into the sofa, that's helping me with the balance, but then I can play with taking my back away from the sofa. I want to find a bit more of my own balance. So I'm just going to do it one sideways. So just for you to work on, like, if you want to work, and then any of you who want to work at the bottom using the floor and the side of the sofa. So here I'm putting my head not too close to the chair, but like, I don't know, like a hand away, like that. Now I put my hands so I can see them. And then I walk my feet until I can feel the edge of the chair. That was a bit too far away. That's about right. Now I can feel the edge of the chair. So I already have this contact. And then I push with my arms, so not pushing, pushing with my hands, push one leg up, push the other leg up. So you don't want to be, so you want to have like, be able to be quite straight. Because then I can, from here, I can bring the weights onto my hands, try to balance it, no contact with the chair, and then back into contact with the chair. No contact, contact. So I can work on my balance. Just make sure that your chair is blocked. So this one is now blocked against my other sofa. Block it against the wall or a cupboard, just so that you don't do it like this, then the chair can fall over and that would be very bad. Yeah, so make sure you block the chair. Let's just do one handstand all together. You okay with that? Just the last one, just to finish on a high. So let's everyone get your chair or your sofa and remember putting one leg up and try push into the night and see if you can make this shape in such a way that you can face the camera. So you can make it your own shape. It doesn't have to be a handstand. It can just be something with your hands and your feet, using the sofa. And you're seeing, you can, yeah, nice. Wow, cool. See if you can change it into something where you have one leg up, something with one leg up in the air. Nice, everyone. Ha. Cool. I'm loving your sofa. And come back to the camera and shake the hands out. So that's the thing we have to do now, really. It's like, you know, when we can't do the classes, you just have to find ways of doing things differently. So it's really nice to like use, just always check with your parents, but it's really nice just use the furniture at home and just make up your own moves that are like safe to do in a small space. So just keep playing with that. Thank you very much. We hope you enjoyed that class. If you did and if you're able, we'd really appreciate any donation, small or big, details below. Also, if you want to join the live Zoom interactive classes, please email us on info@mimbre.co.uk or follow the link below. And also on the Mimbre Youth YouTube channel, there is an acrobatic playlist where you can access more challenges of acrobatic tricks now that you're warmed up. So yeah, enjoy. Hope to see you next week. Bye.